Hey guys, today we're going to be working on this military CUC-V pickup truck. With a 6.2 diesel, and we're going to be installing some glow plugs in here and doing some wiring. So let's put our step on here and get up here to where we can do some work. And this is one of the disadvantages of having your dad edit your videos for you. But that step does make it a lot easier. He was up there working on that truck for quite a while. Now, this is the part we're going to be replacing. Now, these are the glow plugs. For a diesel engine, this is kind of like a spark plug is to a gasoline engine. And what these glow plugs do is a current passes through them, and that heats up this end. And what it does, it warms up the cylinder and lets that diesel fire, so it starts when it's cold. Now, the one on the right's AC Delco. The one on the left is supposed to be an AC Delco, but it's not. This is a true AC Delco glow plug. Now, the one on the left came in an AC Delco box, but there's no engravings or stampings, and it is a little different. The nut is a little bit larger at top, too. So, just be aware, when you buy your glow plugs, if you get them locally, go ahead and open up the box and look in there and make sure it says AC Delco right on them. And there are other brands you can get too, but I prefer these, and so does Jerred. Now, if you'll notice, the one on the left looks okay. It came out. The one on the right is kind of swollen. That can lead to a problem, and a lot of times you get into that on these glow plugs. If they've been changed out routinely, normally you won't have swollen ones and bad shape ones. But some of these may not have been changed out for a long time. So, you got to watch. Sometimes you'll get... Now, this one here looked like it had been changed out not too long ago. Got some soot on there, maybe some carbon buildup. But this one, oh boy, that's swollen. And that ran into trouble. Now, sometimes those are hard to get out of the cylinders when that end swells up like that. But, you know, we've got a remedy, you know, for that in case that happens. Yeah, this is one of the plugs. This is a good looking plug here. There's nothing wrong with that. But, Jerred's going to go ahead and replace them anyway, because like spark plugs, you know, even though if it looks good, well, you know, you got so many miles, maybe every 30,000 miles or so, you'll want to replace them, or you'll end up with something like this. Now, this one, I don't know if that's a factory installed unit or not, but the tip is so swollen on that thing, it'd like to never come out of that cylinder head, and that's bad. When they get like this, you have to have a puller to get that glow plug out of the cylinder. You don't want to twist that off in the head, because that could mean bad things. You may have to remove your cylinder head if one of these twists off in there or pops off inside the cylinder, because there's no other way of getting it out. I suppose if you pulled an injector, you might be lucky enough to get a glow plug out that had been twisted off, but man, you'd be rolling the dice. But what this does, the glow plug fits inside this tool, and then this threaded sleeve just kind of screws down over the top of that. And what it does, that sleeve fits up against the block. You can use the small nut to back out the glow plug. And once it clears the threads, if it's not wanting to pull out of the block, then you can turn the large nut, the sleeve, and that'll work as a puller. And that'll slide that sleeve right out of that glow plug right out of the block. Now, where the glow plugs are located, on each side of the engine, you'll see a wiring harness there. And there's going to be four wires coming down, two in the front, two in the back. And those wires are plugged right directly into your glow plugs. And if you have a problem finding them, just look at your fuel pump lines, trace them down from the fuel pump up there on top of the engine, your injection pump, down there to the fuel injector, the fuel injectors, and the glow plugs are normally right underneath those. They're kind of hard to see. Now these use a 3/8 socket to remove them. You'll need a deep wall socket. And yours may different. Yours may be different. Yours may have a little larger size, maybe a 7/16 or so. Or depending if you've got some of the import parts, it might be a metric. But now these are the GM factory parts here. So these are 3/8 of an inch. Here's a little better angle. You can see just below that injector, there's a little, we can get that. There he goes. Okay, you got the socket on the top of it. You can just barely see the electrical connector on the top of the glow plug sticking out there. But that's enough to get an idea, you know, where it's at. And this is really a hard place to get a good angle for a shot, guys. And I'll tell you what, I was really impressed. There's going to be some shots coming up I was really impressed with. And I got to give Andy and Jerred credit for getting some of the upcoming shots. Now, this is, I feel sorry for Jerry there because he's realizing, you know, it's hard to get a camera angle to where you guys can see and he can see too, you know, without he's doing the two finger shuffle there trying to get that glow plug out. But I believe this is the one, yeah, this was the troublesome one. This was the one that was swollen up. Now it's unthreaded from the head, but it won't pull out of the bore. So that glow plug, has swollen, the heater element side of the glow plug has swollen. And what he's going to do here, and what you can do, is first spray some PB Blaster or some kind of penetrating oil up in there if you can, and just get a good dose on it. And if it's carbon buildup on top, it could loosen up enough to where you can take it out. But as this one turned out, it was not carbon buildup. And the only way to get this one out was to use this glow plug puller. Now this is a specialized tool, and I'm not joking with you guys. These things are not cheap. That thing was like over $100. But you know, if you've got one of these trucks, or you know, if you work on these on a routine basis, it's a good idea to have one, especially if you own one of these. Because if you get into a situation where your glow plug is stuck, this is the only way to get it out. So the big size on the extractor there is a 13/16. I know this is not a good angle, guys, but this is probably as close as they could get you. Yeah, the small end on the extractor is a 7/16. Since there's no easy way to show you this while he's extracting this, how he's doing it, you see he's just trying to get it turned on there. And that happens. And the wrench fell off. But to give you an idea of what's going on, this is the tool. And the glow plug, the swollen glow plug, fits down in that slot inside the tool. Now this one's kind of beat up. Actually, I think this was a factory installed glow plug. Had never been out of the truck. Probably because it had swollen and the previous owner just couldn't get it out. But after you do, you put that on there and that small one will turn, unthread the glow plug. And that'll pull it back out of the cylinder. Now once you get past the threads, you still got the swollen end down there. You can hold the small end and then turn the 13/16 size sleeve with a wrench and it'll pull it out. Now here's a good close-up shot. Now I know it's low light and it's a little grainy, but this is a really good shot that shows you of where the glow plug goes and how he's installing this plug here. Now, he does, I know you can't see it very well in the video, but he does have some anti-seize there during the install. And it's a good idea to always use anti-seize on these, just like spark plugs, you know, because the next fella changing it may be you. So, you know, you got to think about the next guy, especially if you're likely to be the next guy putting a set of these in. And again, you know, I'm not certain what the lifetime or these are, maybe 30,000 miles or maybe more, but, you know, just treat them like a spark plug, and they're around about the same price, you know, anywhere from, I don't know, I think these are probably $8 to $10 each, depending on where you buy them. And there's 8 of them. So, you know, once change them out every 30,000 miles or so, you know, we'll keep your engine starting great. And some of these obviously had been changed out, and I'm certain they were probably working okay. And then you have some of them, like that one swollen one. He's been in there ever since this come from the factory, I would say. Because not many people own that tool to get that thing out, that puller. And this is another angle. It shows him tightening this one down. And I don't know what the torque specs is on these. It's not very much. I'm sure you could look it up online. But, you know, just don't go a He-Man on it. Just about the same as you would a spark plug, or maybe a little less. Now, these are the wires that connect to the glow plugs. And you got to watch out. There is a water temperature sensor on the front of that head that also plugs in. We're not going to be messing with that one. Only the wires that plug into the glow plugs. Now, what Jared's going to do after he removes the glow plugs and changes them out, he's going to cut the ends off of those wires and install fresh connectors. Because most of these connectors are old, they're rusty and corroded, and some of them were even loose. And they all, well, some of them had the plastic insulator cap on them, but some of them, like this one, didn't have it on there. But this is a really good angle they got for removing the glow plug. You can actually see it come right out underneath that injector, so you get a good idea where these things are located. Just right underneath each injector. And you can find the injector by tracing those fuel lines down from the top of the engine. So that glow plug didn't look too bad. It wasn't swollen anyway. That's the wire. And since you're not going to be able to see him, really good angles of him doing this out underneath the hood, he's going to show you, demonstrate how he's going to crimp these on and stuff. Now, these are the gold plated connectors. I think those are 6.3 millimeter, whatever it is. I'll put a link down if you guys are interested in this stuff. But now these are gold plated and a very good connector, better than the factory connectors. I don't know if the factory connectors were tinned, but they seem to have some rust on them, so they might have just been cheap stamp steel connectors. I don't know. And these may be the same thing, but they do have a gold plating over them, so that's much better contact, less chance of corrosion. And also, it'd be a good transfer of power. Now, this wire stripper, I think Jared got that one from Horror Freight. I'm not certain. But, you know, you can use whatever wire stripper you got. And the crimper, you know, this he's got one of these pliers type. And these are pretty good. They do a lot of different connectors. You just got to kind of watch and kind of match up what connector you're crimping. You know, you got to use the right hole for the connector. And Jared's doing something here that I like to do. He he's crimping the part, the portion of the connector down and making it round, the part that holds the wire, before he inserts the wire in there. And I like doing it that way too. And the reason being is that kind of keeps you from having a loose strand of wire that didn't make it inside of the connector. You know what I mean? And you just use your wire crimper pliers there and crimp it down. Yeah, this is one of the plugs that came out. This looks pretty good, this glow plug. Now these connectors here, yeah, that's a good snap on there, and it's tight. That's a good fit. Now the stock ones were really loose. Kind of messed up on his little crimp on that one little bit, but that's okay. This is just a demonstration. Now these are the nylon covers that go on the end of those terminals. And actually, you know, you wouldn't think, but these are really important. That insulates that from anything touching it. Because when you first turn the key on these diesels, it has a timer that kicks on and it applies power. I believe it's 12 volts to these glow plugs. And of course, you know, that's what keeps the glow plug. The little glow plug starts heating up, and then after it heats up for maybe, I don't know, 20, 30 seconds, whatever, it kicks back off and then you start the engine. And so during that time, that terminal, you don't want a bare naked terminal out there, because if something was to hit against it, it could ground it out, and that would cause a direct short to ground. Now, what Jared's demonstrating here is these only fit in the connector one way. So you can't get it wrong. Once it goes in there, that thing has a nice snap and it locks into place. Well, it's really tight getting it in there. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, once that snaps into place, it's not coming back out of there. So this one is good to go. So we have a new terminal. That clicks right onto the spade terminal of the glow plug, and it is tight now. Now we're not going to have to worry about any issues with poor connectivity. See, this one's the old factory one. Man, that looks corroded. And it was loose on the glow plug, too. Really, really bad idea to keep those. So it's always a good idea to replace them. He's just going to start off stripping the wire on the truck, just like he did inside for the demonstration. Twist him up there good, and you guys know the rest. That's the way to go. Once he puts his terminal on there, he'll be good to go. Oh yeah. Starts much better. Much better. And looks like we're at the end of the video. And this has been how to install your glow plugs and your 6.2 diesel. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. We'll see you next time.